Hey guys, happy Thursday! It's New Black Thursday tonight. Thanks so much for coming in, replay viewers, and thanks YouTube viewers for watching. YouTube viewers, if you'd like to watch live, you can join me on Periscope. Just download the app to your phone. I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central. Just search for Penguin and Fish. Thanks for coming in, guys. I'm going to flip you around and we'll get started for the night. Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for coming in. Happy Thursday. It is New Black Thursday. Cute block. It's a little applique coffee cup with all these fancy triangles around it. I'm kind of excited. This is a really fun way to do a whole pile of triangles like this. I think it's going to be really easy, and I think it's going to be quicker than it seems. So I'm excited about that. So tonight I think we'll do all the triangle parts, or at least get as far as we can on that, and then tomorrow we'll get going on the applique. I might not be here tomorrow evening. It's my husband's he's premiering his short film to the cast and crew at our house tomorrow, so we'll be doing that, but if it ends a little early, then I'll come in. Otherwise, I'll be here on Saturday and we'll do that applique and probably finish it up, I'm hoping. I think it'll go pretty quickly. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central. So I'm going to flip you around, and we will get going on these triangles right away. Thanks again for being here, guys. Okay, back to the land of blue fabrics. I'm doing a relatively blue quilt. I'm trying to get more blue back into it, so I chose these for close blues, but they're all a little different for all these background triangles. So it doesn't look like it really says, but based on the image, it looks like there's four different colors. So that's what I got going on here. So let's start on that right away. Yep, my books are both on Amazon, Sew and Stitch Embroidery, and then the other book is No Monster Here. No Monster Here, make sure that you're buying it from Penguin and Fish, because there's some weird resellers for that. That's, you know, Amazon's kind of goofy sometimes. But, alright, so this is block 76. We need to start out with 12. Oh, cool, you have it! That's awesome. I start out with 12, 3, and an eighth inch squares. So that eighth inch is important. We're doing like a whole pile of diagonal cutting, and that requires some of these special measurements. I don't quite know how to figure all that out yet, but okay, so three and an eighth inch squares cut from the sorted prints. That's what we're doing here. So we need three of each to make it be 12. So I need to cut like at least about 9.5 inches worth from all of these. So how I'm going to start is, let's just find a spot on all of these that's around 9.5 inches, and I'm going to stack all four of these at once. Oh, and then I think for the middle, the center square, I think I'm going to do this light dot again. So this will be all bordered around this light dot, and then the applique will go in there. But we won't get that far tonight, I don't think. Let's move some of these guys out of the way. Okay, 9.5 inches. I wonder if this short area is 9.5. It might just barely be there. All right, it's 10, so we can do that edge here. Let's see, what else? Oh, these are both really big yet, so one of those for sure will be, yeah, these are basically fat quarter form yet. So there's plenty of edge there. What about here? This last piece. Ooh, wow, there's a lot on here too. Great. So that will work out just fine. We'll flip it this way. And I will put this on top because this is the shortest one. So I'm gonna spray these all down with some starch and press them first, but then we will be ready to go. So let's go up to the ironing board. And we'll spray these edges one at a time. I love this blue. It is just so bright and pretty. Bright, bright, bright. Okay, let's spray them really well. We're doing a lot of triangles and angles again, and I think my iron's got to warm up. But those like to stretch, so I'm spraying it with a bunch of starch just to hopefully reduce some of that stretching. I'm hoping that we'll be a little bit more accurate because of that. There we go. Steaming a little bit. So a lot happened in the rest of that game since we were talking about it at the top of the eighth last night. So I think that was kind of funny. Getting all comfortable, top of the eighth. All right. So that's the first one. Ooh, I can definitely feel that there's a bunch of starch on that. That's perfect. Let's get the next bit. Oops. Sorry, guys. This is a really pretty blue, too. Oops. There's the sizzle. So one of these, the darkest color, is that kind of batik-looking dyed one. I think that one may stain my ironing board a little bit, but, you know, it can just hang out with all the rest of the stains. All right. Second piece. So I'm trying to line them up as I go here, too, a little bit. Okay, next up, get this little edge here. This is actually the wrong side. Wrong side of the fabric, or the back of the fabric. Yeah, you know what? I think it's probably not going to work out for me to be here tomorrow during because it'll be my husband's little thing for the cast and crew. And I have to clean up my whole area here, my little scoping area. So our kitchen and dining room could be a usable space again for the evening. So I don't think I'll have time to set it all back up. So yeah, so we better just count on maybe Saturday picking this up again. All right, and then, there we go, this piece here. Then we're ready to cut and sew. There, don't need the starch anymore. Put that away. Oh, maybe I'll have to do like a little, I don't know, maybe he'll let me do a little scope. Oh, yeah, barely. Every once in a while, though, a little bit of life comes through, though. Oh, it's on tonight? Oh, see, okay, I didn't know what, I watched yesterday, so I got caught up with the current episode yesterday. I didn't know that it airs Thursday, so, okay. So if you see, I think I was wearing a white t-shirt, so way back across the street when the people are outside, if you see someone with a white t-shirt and someone standing real tall next to her, that might be me. Oh, lost my ruler, but here we are. In the previews. Oh, funny. In the previews, I couldn't, it didn't look like we were there. But I don't know. We'll see. I'll have to watch it. I can't watch it live, but I'll watch it like next day. And we'll see how it goes. I'm not making any little finger foods, but the Hubs is buying little finger foods right now. Well, I don't think we'll be cooking anything. And I think we're just kind of doing like, I don't know what we're doing. Do you have any good suggestions? I'm not very good at all that stuff. So we need three and an eighth. So, I don't have that measurement on here very well. Oh, there we go. Three and an eighth. Oh, yeah. I'm trying to, you know, he's trying to think of things, and I'm trying to think of things that you don't have to, that are like pop in your mouth type things that you don't have to be carrying a whole pile of stuff around with you. All right. There we go. One, two, three, and an eighth. All right. We should be good. And I only need about 9.5 inches. So I'm going to just kind of trim it to here and then cut over. So there we go. And then we'll cross cut. So I'm just going to go right like that. Whoa! Drop my ruler on the other side of the table. All right. That's maybe a little bit wasteful, but it's fine. Yeah, I think we're gonna do veggie, oh, cheese balls, that's a good idea. And they can all hunt for TV on the Blackwell. Haha, yeah, we're gonna show it in the basement. We got a little projector, and we're gonna do it there. But yeah. Our weird TV on the black wall. We haven't repainted. We had a drill. Our studs in that wall are 24 or like something like 24 inches apart. So we had to, it took forever to find the stud for the wall. So we have tons of tiny little pilot hole drill holes that we haven't painted over yet. Kind of hanging out all weird there. All right. So 3 1/8. By 3 1/8. All right. And we need three of these. So there's the first one. 3 1/8. It's a weird measurement for my ruler. Yeah, that sounds really good. I didn't think of like a cheesy thing. That makes total sense. We should do like a little cheese and meat platter or something. Yeah, so he's getting that stuff. We still have to clean up and everything around here, so that'll probably be all our morning and afternoon. And you know, there's actual work to get done tomorrow a little bit too. All right. And here's our third. Alrighty, so we're set already. That cutting wasn't too terrible. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna match a few colors up. So I kind of debated whether being totally random or not, but I think I'm not gonna be random. I think I'm gonna do all of them the same. So here are these three. This one doesn't have a right or wrong side. And then why don't we pair those up with maybe one of these colorful solids. Maybe like that. So these two, we'll just make these two go together every single time. So, these two will be together, and these two together. Oh yeah, so hummus, I think he's getting some naan and hummus, and then some veggies, but I like that cheese idea. We should do that. we're trying to be a little healthier and go less, like, just straight up chips and stuff, but I think he might get some pretzels and that sort of thing. But, all right, I think this is how we're going to do it. So I will, we'll start out by pairing up these. So what we're going to do again with right sides together, and again, these neither of these have right sides, which is kind of funny, but we're going to put them together, and we're going to do that thing where we draw a line down the center, and then sew on either side of that line, and we're going to do that for all these, and then cut down the middle. So let's just get going on that. I'm going to just, let's just pair these up. You're hungry now. I'm going to pair these up, and then we'll draw lines on the back of all of them, and then we will sew on either side. It's crazy. These squares feel so big. I haven't sewn a square this big in a long time, just because our Splendid Sampler blocks end up being so tiny all the time. These will end up being tiny because we're going to cut them up quite a bit, but right now they seem so big. All right, and then we'll put these two together. It'll be easy to see on this light-colored side. This one, again, doesn't have a right or wrong side. This is really the only fabric that has a right and wrong side in this case. So that's kind of funny. And last one. All right, so let's draw our lines on these. I think I'm going to just use a pencil. You can use really whatever you want. I mean, she's using, in the pattern, she suggests a micron pen, which is basically kind of like a black permanent marker. The reason it doesn't matter all that much is because we're going to cut on that line. So, all right, I'm going to just do this for all of these right away. Stand up yet. Thought I could do this sitting down, but it's easier standing up and going right over the top. I just need to be able to see this line. Well, I'm missing all your guys' yummy suggestions. Alright, that one's good. Such a fun block. Yeah, I'm pretty excited for this one. It's one of those ones that look like there's a whole lot of difficulty and stuff going on, but it's actually in the end pretty easy, I think. And that little coffee cup's so cute. I might actually change the coffee cup a little. I think the coffee cup's perfectly cute as is, but I kind of like collecting coffee cups like from the Value Village and stuff like that. Or I used to. I haven't bought any new ones in a while, but I might pick one of my own and kind of draw it in the shape of one of my own coffee cups just for fun. We'll see though. We'll see how we feel on Saturday. Ooh, artichoke. Ooh, with crazy cheesy crab dip. Holy cow, that sounds really good. I'll have to bring that up when he gets back. I think we'll go get cheesy crab dip sounds like amazing. We'll probably go tomorrow morning and get some more, maybe. Ooh, baked, yum. And I think my parents are coming tomorrow afternoon to help, so they can help with food stuff too, maybe. All right, two more. There are all these kind of little finicky steps with these, doing all those squares and triangles that I always forget about that take a little while, but so we'll get as far as we can on this tonight. Oh, one of those tasty recipes. I love those. it's a cast and crew screening of my husband's short film that he made. So, we decided to have it at our house instead of somewhere else because it was just going to work out the best. And, the cast and crew who helped him on his short film will all be coming, and he'll be showing the film, and they'll be just hanging out and eating and chit-chatting and seeing each other again, and it'll be kind of fun. All right, Here we go. Let's sew these. So I'm going to go a scant quarter on either side of these. So, all right. So what I'm going to do is, this is kind of representing my scant quarter. I'm going to put my pencil line right on there. And I'm going to get my little stiletto in here to help things out. There we go. Now we'll just feed it through. Trying to be kind of precise. I'm still working on the straight lines and all that. And the scant quarter. So we're sewing on the bias, which is the 45 degree angle of the thread. So the fabric's woven this way and this way. And so we're sewing on that diagonal, and that diagonal is stretchy. And that's why we sprayed it with a bunch of starch to hopefully keep it in its place a little bit better. I had a little vision before I started this evening that, oh, I haven't checked the bobbin in a long time, so we'll see if we randomly run out of bobbin today. I don't know, that'd be super weird, but I haven't thought about the bobbin in a while, and I thought about it, so don't know. These three, and then we still have to sew the other sides of all these. Oh, dedication rose. Oh gosh, you needle turned it all. Yeah, I think that's the one that I'm needle turning that one too, and I'm way, way, way far from being done on that one. Ooh, it's bunching up all. Oh my gosh, you guys, we totally just did run out of bobbin. Look at, I can feel it. Funny, that is totally weird. All right, I guess we gotta get new bobbin. I think I might have some wound already of that gray. funny. All right, let's see. I either have it sitting out in here or I gotta wind some. I think we gotta wind some. All right, let's do it. I haven't, I'll point you guys up towards the bobbin. I haven't wound the bobbin since I got it back from the machine fixer. So we'll see how it goes. I know, bobbin thread, right? I'm telling you, I thought of it like right before. Oops! Dropped the bobbin. Right before I started today, I'm like, oh man, haven't had to do the bobbin in a while. it's just funny. Okay, let's get this guy winding. Oh yeah, metal bobbins. Oh, this is running so much smoother. It used to rattle a lot, and it's not at all now. I can think of, so you put a spool in the bobbin as well. Yeah, really. I know, right? I have ESP today. Fill this guy all the way up. All right, so I'm gonna just tighten the wheel again, and we're back in business here, people. All right, let's get back down here. I'll thread this guy while I'm hanging out. Needle up. All right. Get in there. I know the Orfill take goes, I know, doesn't it? It looks just so clean and fancy. The Orfill is so thin that it really does go a long way on the bobbin. It's kind of neat. So I always remember, you know, my bobbin has this arm on it. I always think that goes towards me and the thread goes away from me over the top. So that's kind of how I remember to put the bobbin in. Towards and away. All right, let's find my wheel again, or my pedal. Okay, we are threaded and ready to go. Oh, wait, did something, oh, it's just a little thread. I thought my, thought I had, something fall down in here, but nope. Okay, let's get started again. Where were we? So we got these three done. Get those out of the way, and we're starting this one. Suppose we can pick out those couple of threads that went in there. There we go. Whew, all right, let's do it. Figure out how to make it darker. That's about the best we can do. Get all these squares made. I don't know if we'll get all the like four triangle squares sewn together tonight, but I'm gonna try and get them all made. All right, so that's all of those. Let's get the other side of these. Concentrating on sewing straight and everything. Alright. Get this guy started. Then we have the three that we started with. Let me get this leader off. All right, these three. Oh, I thought that was a little bubble. It just got a little thread. I thought it was maybe a skip in the thread, but it's not. Oh. Well, I'm working at it. I think there's still a hair scant, but oh well. Concentrating. All right, this is our last one here. All right, I'm cutting this guy away.
He's in my way.
Okay, let's get an ender, one of the enders in there. All right, we are sewn. So let's snip all these. And then we will cut all of these down on that center line. And we will have ourselves some half square triangles. Half square triangle, round one, basically. All right. Here we are. I know it's nice to have the machine back. I do want to play with the other one a little bit more still, but you know, it's nice to have this one back too. Okay, I don't need my bobbins anymore. Let's cut these guys in half. Ooh, a quilt retreat tomorrow. That sounds like fun. Any special thing that you'll be making there? All right, so we sewed on either side, and now we're going to cut right down the middle, which is the diagonals, and we made two half square triangles from that. So I'm going to get these guys, just start stacking them up so I can press them. What does it say to press? Pin the pairs together and sew quarter in line, then cut on the center line, press the seams to the darker fabric. Okay, to the darker fabric. That's what we'll do. Press the darker fabric. Okay, that's the second pairing. This would be fun to do on a bigger quilt, just a whole pile of these squares, I think. I think it would be fun. UFOs? Oh, nice. Oh, cool. So you get to bring your own project. That's nice. All right. These ones will look like this. What's the darker side? I'm thinking this is probably considered darker. They're about the same. The value is how light or dark something is, and I kind of picked pretty similar values. Ooh, Wisconsin, yay! It's supposed to be beautiful! Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weekend, rest of the week and weekend, I think. All right, let's press these guys open to the dark side. Alright, how I like pressing to the dark side is I have the dark side on top, and I set the seam a little bit. Ooh, watch enjoy the colors, exactly, sounds so nice. And I kind of like finger pressing them open a little bit. There we go. So that's one. We'll just make a little stack down here. So the fun part comes next, I think, because we'll be pairing up these half square triangles with each other and then sewing along the other diagonal. Oh, I was only thinking there was like three of these too, but we've cut them in half, so there's six of each of these now. They're multiplying, which is kind of funny. They're gradually multiplying and gradually shrinking in size. That's three. This is where these guys get me. It's all this pressing and the pressing kind of throws me. I always forget how much time it takes to press, you know, 12 of something. Oh, that's neat. I don't think I've really been to a quilt retreat before. I've been to like a little crafty thing, but not like a full-on quilt retreat. That just sounds nice and relaxing. I would want to do something though where I could drive there, because then I don't know. I think it'd be really pretty difficult to fly with a sewing machine. I've never done that before. I know a lot of people do that. That just sounds like hard work. All right, here's the other one. We have six of these. Ooh, a paint retreat. That would be kind of fun. I brought some of my paints home that I used in class last week. I kind of want to try a little painting. Maybe I'll try painting something this weekend. I don't know if I like really don't have the time for that, but I have to prep our board for the last class. It's like the singular homework that we've had. We have to put gesso, which is basically white acrylic paint, I guess, to a board and bring it into class. So I thought while I'm painting that one, I might as well paint a bunch of other little things to get ready to do a painting with. Then maybe Sunday I'll fit in a little painting during the day or something. I don't know. We'll see. I like the thought of that. I just gotta figure out the timing. These are so pretty too. I like this one. Now all we have to do is match them up. Really, we're done here. Sew some more diagonals and ultimately, we're not going to trim these ones down. We'll trim the final squares down to the right size. So once we get the other half of this thing done, then we'll be sure to make it the right size before we sew them all together. Oops, that didn't press very well. All right, I think we're good. Let's check it out. So now we need to take all of these ones and match them up with these. So what we're gonna be doing is, I can't grab one of those, there we go. We're gonna be matching them up, you know, like this. Oh, we can kind of nest the seams a little bit. And then we'll be drawing a line down this edge and then sewing on either edge, like how we did it to begin with, but now we're doing it with like little these triangle things. So what I'm gonna do is, I think I'm going to first just draw lines on the backs of all of these, and these will be our top piece that we match together. So let's do that first, our little line. So again, we gotta take time to do these lines. Move that away from my ruler. But if it wasn't for these, I would not be sewing these guys very straight. All right, that looks good. I think I'm doing this right. I'm not actually sure I've done this before. It's gonna look cute. I'm excited to see the finished look. So I can get Lifetime, which is what Project Runway is on Apple TV, but I don't know if they post them the same day or the next day. So I don't know. Maybe I'll have to stay up and watch a Project Runway tonight and see if we're in it. That would be cool. But that's interesting, though. So we were there in New York when they filmed this Project Runway in July. So early July. Oh, it's just my label that I put on when I make, like, stuffed animals and quilts and stuff. I have a little penguinfish label that, you know, I don't know, I stuck it on here. I made this for some other random thing, and it was laying around, and I'm like, oh, that looks like it'll fit on a pencil, so I just threw it on there. But yeah, so we were there early July, and now it's early November. So what is that? That's like 5 months, July, August, September, October, November. Oh, 4 months. So it took them 4 months to edit it and put it together or whatever. Kind of interesting. All right. Here we are. Seems so long ago. No kidding, right? Okay, so I want to make sure that I'm doing these all in the same direction so that I can just grab them and do them in the same direction. So those are all the same direction. So are these. Okay. So I'm going to just kind of bop these together like so. You know, this might be an opportunity to use Wonder Clips. I think I'm going to do that. So let's grab some Wonder Clips. You like the girl with the funny laugh? I think she's funny. I think some of the things she says, though, like in the off camera, in the, you know, like the diary booth or whatever they call those things these days, are just weird. But I like her. I like her stuff that she's been doing lately for designs. I kind of like the blonde girl that they yelled at in the last episode. That does all the embroidery stuff, but she's got some weird attitude thing, like, I'm so good sort of thing, too. It's the one that was from when we were in New York. You know what? I think I'm going to just go through and pin all these like this while I'm at it. I think it's kind of slick. I'm just nesting the seams together and basically lining up the edges. It's the one that's going to be new. It was, we happened to be in New York when they filmed the episode. It was a whole thing where, from what I could gather and based on the preview, I'm pretty sure this is it. It's top 9 because there was 9 outfits made and it was a group challenge, because they did like 3 mini collections and then they had each collection in a window down in Soho where like outside people could vote on it or whatever. Pedestrians, the people could vote on them on what they liked the best and stuff. So, and they had like people walk by it and stuff, and for that, we could have stood in line to try and be one of those people, but, you know, we were pretty sweaty and gross by then. I'm thinking they would be like, no. If we stood in line for that. I think I was wearing a necklace that day that had totally, we were sweating and walking all day, and I think the necklace turned my neck green and fun stuff like that. I don't know if what I'm doing here is really necessary, but I don't know. I'm halfway done with it now. Yeah, because we're gonna be sewing it either side. So we do really want these seams to match up still, because we're gonna be seeing them. So I think what I'm doing here is fine. Nesting the seams. Trying to get them together. Not lined up very good here. Wand eclipse. Yeah, we'll see how this goes. Wow, this one seems weird, but it might just be how I pressed it. There we go. It's getting a little bit better. Two more sets. We're getting there. So we'll quickly sew these and cut them, and we'll probably press them too. So we might be a little late tonight. Just takes what it takes, I suppose. But I'd like to get this part of it done. Is on until 4 a.m. Sheesh. All right, last one, and then we'll get sewing. Again, we're gonna do the exact same thing. We're gonna sew on either side of the pencil line. What color am I doing for the mug for this? I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna see what this looks like, kind of lay it all out. I think I'm gonna do that white fabric that I have with the purple little polka dots. I think I'll do that as my background piece for the coffee cup, but I'm not quite sure what colors I'm gonna use for the actual coffee cup yet. I figured this would take us long enough that we wouldn't get to that, so. All right, let's sew these guys. I'm itching to see what this looks like. Ooh, that would be kind of pretty. Yeah, I haven't done the orange or red in a while. It'd be nice to have like a little pop of color again, wouldn't it? So, that's not a bad idea. All right, let's sew on either side of these. Okay, we'll just keep grabbing from our pile here. The red with the tree, that would be kind of neat too. I forgot about that one. Oh, that one we might be able to fussy cut a little bit. Get a little seagull or one of the little animals that's hiding in it on the coffee cup. I kind of like that idea. And then we have that pop of red, which is kind of fun. We haven't done. I've been like stuck on this blue for a while. The last couple blocks we added in some of that white and a little bit of yellow, but yeah, maybe it's time to start popping in some of those colors again. Once we trim them all, we have to trim these all down to 2 inches or something, I think. And I'm hoping that they'll trim okay. Then they'll all line up fine. They'll all be what they're going to be. How about that? All right, 2 more, and then we have to go back around the corner. The other direction. Last one. I'm getting excited. I want to see them. Oh, I sewed these in a little bit different direction, I think. Oh well, doesn't matter. Alright, so I think I can just hook on this guy and flip him around and then come up the other side. There we go. That'll do it. This is some chain piecing. Ah! Winter clips want to get stuck in everything, though. Yeah, it looks like a kite. It totally does, doesn't it? With all these little legs coming off. It's pretty cute, I think. I like these colors. And these wonder clips are sure coming in handy, though. That was a fun little splendid sampler purchase. I mean, with a template. Oh, I'm not sure. What are we talking about with the template? Are we talking about the coffee mug? I think I missed the conversation a little bit. Come on, guy, hanging out down here. Alright, just two more. That wasn't too bad. Alright, last one. Oops, I folded over the tip of it a little. Okay, get this guy in here, and that's that. Let's snip it off. All right, here we go. Let's get rid of all the wonder clips. It's kind of funny like this, isn't it? Oh, separate templates, like without doing the chain piecing and stuff. Yeah. All right, wonder clips, you are done. I finally got the hang of opening this thing, like sticking the, doing every triangle and sewing all the triangles instead of this whole like square and then cross cutting the square thing. Yeah, that'd be tough. It'd be tough for me at least. All right. These cute guys. And again, we're just gonna cut along these pencil lines, and then we'll see what we got here. A little thread there. Okay. So let's do that. Give us some more space here. Ruler. So again, I'm just cutting on that diagonal. I'm excited. Okay. Here's our fancy squares. Ah! Cute! I like it. I think these are pretty subtle, I think, with these colors. But look! How cool is that? Just with our, you know, doing this, those two little bits. It's just really two steps. We sew those first pairs together, and then we sewed the pairs together. Kind of magic. All right, let's finish cutting them. And then we will, are these pressed to the dark side? Let me see. Oh, press the seams open. Okay, fine. We'll press these open. I hate pressing open, but we'll do it. It's getting bulky, so that makes sense. Yeah, I would never be able to cut perfect little triangles exact enough to attempt it that way either. And why, when this way is so easy and fun? Hmm. excited to see what these look like. So we still have to cut these down to 2 inches, but I'll do that a different time. I'll try and press these all tonight, though. There's a lot of them, though. I think there's probably, yeah, there's still 12. But, you know, it takes time.
Time to press.
But we'll have a pile of cute little guys done. Last one. I love this technique. Just sewing on both sides and cutting in the middle. Nice slick. All right, let's press all of these open. And I don't think I'm gonna trim them all tonight. We'll be here forever if I start doing that, but I'll press them open. So I'm gonna just press to one side first, and then I'll press them open. Ah, cute. So now we can see if we lined up the centers well and stuff too. So all right, now I'm gonna kind of finger press this open. Run down the center there. All right, and give it one more press from the front. Okay, 11 more times, so it does take a little while to do the pressing, but look how cute! I think it looks just fun. We kind of have the solids, like an hourglass, and the, you know, barely, like, practically solids, but not quite going the other way, but that's a good-looking point, too. I'm not sure if she started this yet. I haven't, I didn't get a text with her magically being, with her being done with it or anything like that, so I'm not sure if she's finished it or not. I'd like to think that she's packing, because they're gonna come here tomorrow morning and help with John's movie stuff. Alright, open up that seam. This is so futsy, all this pressing. I don't know. Still my least favorite. We'll lay that here, though. Then we can see the cute black, at least. One more press from the front. All right. So we'll start, like, rotating these and playing with the direction of things next. Oh, these are opposite. Ah, just keep stacking. All the kitty ears, I know, right? So when we trim this down to 2 inches, I wonder how big these are. They're much bigger than 2 inches. So we'll for sure trim all this off and it'll be perfectly fine. They all look like they're about 2 1/4 inch. So there's definitely wiggle room. And no finger foods. It'll be a finger food supper, I'm thinking. You hate trimming more than pressing? Eh, I don't know. I kind of don't mind the trimming. But yeah, that it just adds up. You know, in my head, I don't mind the trimming, but then when I have to do 12 of them, I'm like, oh yeah, crap, I have to do 12 of these. I don't know. I just don't like burning my fingers all the time. I still have that funny bump in my ironing board. It's time to get a new one of these. I don't know, if I remember and I'm at Target for something tomorrow for the party, maybe I'll sneak in one of these new little tiny mini ironing boards. I know we talked about covering it and other little pads, but I don't know. It's just easy to just get one of these. I think we're about halfway done. All the centers are looking really nice, though, so that's exciting. Got to nest the seams and use those lumber clips that kind of held things together really well. That's so crazy that we ran out of bobbin thread. Like 2 seconds after I mentioned it.
Funny.
Okay. Come on now. Open up. There we go. So I think I have, I don't know, how many more? 1, 2, 3. Oh man. I think I still have 6 of these. I know, right? Where is it? I wonder what she's up to. Has she been here for a while? I don't think so. There's not yet. I think he might just throw it up on YouTube or something, or Vimeo once, he's entered it in a few more, shows, but I think he definitely wants to make it available, so I'll for sure let you guys know, once it's watchable somewhere. But yeah. Oh, Cassie came up. I don't know if I've seen her for a while, but she was one of the early on Periscope people here, and she was in charge of telling me, oh yeah, PAX 2. I mean, maybe because we've just been working on the Splendid Sampler and haven't been working on other projects. I know we've lost a couple people because of that. So I don't know, maybe once we get going on some other projects, when this project's done. So back to some embroidery and, you know, some mending and other fun random craft projects. Maybe we'll see some of those old peeps again. Just some people that were here with us on Periscope before we started the Splendid Sampler and everything. But yeah, Kathy was in charge of warning me to check my bobbin. I think what were we doing? We were making a quilt, I think, actually, and we kept running out of thread, so kept running out of bobbin. But the Hubs is back with the finger foods. I think we were working on that funny quilt where we did all those random cuts. I made a quilt where I made like the front of a quilt, and then I put like a solid color underneath, and then I just slashed it all over the place and then like sewed it back together. And I think that's what we were working on. I think we were using some of that thicker 12 weight. Maybe we weren't yet. I was thinking maybe we were using some of that 12 weight Aurifil, and we kept running out of that all over the place. Okay, there's only, oh, there's still 4 of these yet, guys. I kind of want to lay them out quick and see what we got going on yet too, but wow. Yeah, just this pressing. I mean, we've been pressing for 10 minutes already about. Oh, gosh, can that really be? That seems like so long. Guess so, though. Maybe when the Splendid Sampler is done, I'll have to send an email out and be like, hey, we're done with the Splendid Sampler, so if you're sick of watching the Splendid Sampler on Periscope, I'm doing other stuff now. Oh, yep, he's whistling. He's a whistler. All right, 2 more after this one. Ah, we're getting there. They're like endless, this ironing. I couldn't actually imagine doing a whole quilt like this. It would just be a lot. Press the front again. Yeah, the other thing with the iron is that I'm just, like, sweating now, because I know I miss the frog, too. We won't have those again until next year. Cute little evening froggies. John just made a frog noise. put it up there. Sounded like a frog noise. Oh, you're working on a paper piecing project. That's awesome. I bet you we'll have another one of those pop up soon again. Oh, you heard him. All right, last one, guys. Oh, man. Pressing for days. That's what we're doing here. All right, let's, I think all the centers, though, look good. So that's exciting. All the center points. There we go. And then we will flip around in the last little press, and we'll be done with this part of it at least. I kind of want to quickly see what it looks like without wasting too much more time, but I'm kind of excited about it. So here we go. Let's lay them out. So many cute little squares. Let's just, I'm going to just randomly plop them down. I'm not going to really pay attention to what they look like. We'll just kind of be random about it. So this will go in our, this will be our cute little square. So since my colors, they are pretty subtle because I chose things that were, the values are pretty close to each other. But they're still, still pretty cute, I think. All right, and then two down here. And so then I'm going to put, I think, I know I need I need like a TA ironer or something, or a production assistant. So there we go. Then I'm gonna do this fabric in the middle, and then we still have the applique, so the little tiny coffee cup applique will go in here, and I don't know, I think red, like the red coffee cup with that tree, with the, like one of those little, let's just grab that, I think I can grab it from here. Yeah, so, you know, like with this little apple on or something, preferably with some of this blue, would be super cute on this, wouldn't it? Okay, I think we're gonna do... I know there's an animal in here somewhere. They're hard to find. I'm trying to unfold this thing. It's crazy though. And we might have used that little seagull already. Oh, here we go. We got a little seagull there. I mean, if we didn't want to do, we could just do a little coffee cup like this with a little seagull. That might be kind of cute too. I don't know. We'll see, but I like the idea of this red. So I think that's the plan. So we'll pick this up again Saturday. Again, I'll probably be MIA tomorrow, but thanks for hanging out with me for the rest of this. I mean, what a cool technique to make these, like hourglass things. And yeah, all of the center points turn out great. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around and we will call it an evening. Love the red for the applique. Yeah, I think that'll be fun. But yeah, so here we go. Here is the ending size. You know, these blocks were nice too, or these little segments, because, we were sewing with a little bit bigger pieces than we normally were. But yeah, cute. So, all right, I will get this up on YouTube tonight. Thanks again so much, guys, for being here. I am, like, so in love with these. We just made, like, 100 of these things. Or 12. But, you know, it felt like a lot. So, oh, thanks, guys. I will let you know for sure how it goes. And, of course, I will let you know when it goes, when his movie is out in the world for real. I'll send you guys a link or let you know what it is. So, all right, I will check you guys out on Saturday. Have a great Friday and a great start of your weekend. I'll see you soon. Good night, guys.